Yes, this is wonderful. I like to hear Helmi because it is part of what I want to tell you. I want to speak about culture of tomorrow, and I mean especially today food culture and agriculture. And when we want to go from 1.0 to 3.0, we need first to evolve in our beliefs and attitudes. And I want to ask first, how much caring can you include in difficult decisions? Am I able only to think of me? This is the ethnocentric way. Or look on my family or my group or the people I love, the sociocentric or ethnocentric? Or can I include in my caring all of us, which means the world-centric view? And it was not so easy for me to go on this worldview because I come from the political movement and we thought all the time it's enough when we change our taxes and laws. And I do know this is very important to work on these issues. But I have learned it is also necessary to change attitudes, beliefs, thoughts, feelings. So I want to speak about evolving world views. We start with the traditional view, 1.0, and have gone to the modern world view, 2.0. We call it this biosphere, and go to postmodern view, 3.0. And now we are in this wonderful modern system. We use nature for our success. We want to make the work, the business work for people and for the planet. And we have all the problems which this worldview brings with us. We heard from our first speaker. And now we want to go to the 3.0, to the postmodern view. And this is a very complex view. It understands nature, and it is able to work with diversity and with systems, especially with ecosystems. And we all come from a traditional view. We all started in the 70s, and we were very eager to protect nature. And in Germany, we have a special history with this because Hans Karl von Carlowitz started in 1713 and used this word, this German word, nachhaltend, which is the sustainability. And here we can see how valuable is this traditional knowledge, because I want take the best of all these worldviews. We need the best of tradition, the best of modernity, and the best of postmodernity, because the modernity brought us a lot of very important progress. It is for our education systems, for our health systems, for very effective production, and it brought a lot of technical and scientific differentiation. And this is and was very fascinating for all of us. And it's dangerous because it denies, or it tends to deny, values. It tends to lose ethics. It tends to excessive consumism. And so we need to go to this 3.0. And many people on this fair have spoken about the days before, and we are all people who have all three in us. And what I want to invite you to make yourself conscious about, where are you driven from? And therefore we need a balance between interior and exterior factors. Because the degree of caring shows what we do comes from how we think, feel, believe. And our attitudes drive our choices and decisions. So I speak here with the integral map, which has four systems: the interior individual, which is the psychological influences and the individual mindsets. It's the interior collective, and both are the interior side of our acting. So this is where our intentions most come from. And we have the exterior side, the behavioral side, and the systems side, where most of our ecologic approaches are working. And all of them, all four perspectives on every phenomena is important. We cannot leave one of them. And we have been avant-garde for a lot of innovative concepts on the exterior side. We have many wonderful projects, and we need much more of them. SECAM is one. And we also need to have more impact on taxes and on laws and on subsidies. And we do a lot of work in this exterior side. Here in Märkisch Landbrot, we work with Economy for the Common Good. We have made the the balance. We have many initiatives for transition towns, for green cities. We saw it in Berlin 2 weeks ago at the great green fashion. We spoke about urban farming, about zero waste, reduce, reuse, recycle. These are all very, very important things, and we have to work on them. And we also have made a lot of solutions. We have made proposals for solutions for the big world problems. I think especially on the book of Felix zu Löwenstein, Food Crash, he made solutions for these real world problems. But now, also, eco-agriculture, we heard it, and trading has become part of the problems. This is the problematic part and impact of modernity. It brings a lot of knowledge, and this is very necessary, but it is not enough. It is also enough to change beliefs, attitudes, and so on. So here is the integral developmental map again, and we can see the most ecologic approaches provide solutions for the external behavior side. And we need to balance all four sides, because the internal side is that it's the side that drives our actions. This is the side of culture and spirit, what Helm spoke about. And this takes time, a lot of time. So here we come to the interior factors. And we have these wonderful postmodern communication processes. Here we are in one of these processes. I hope we will have a wonderful dialogue, not only discussion, and speak together in this round. And we have wonderful people speaking about not only sustainability, but also sufficiency and more life-work balance, less is more, slow down, transparency. Transparency is a wonderful example. You can see the level of consciousness if a person speaks about transparency. It's very different from every level of personal consciousness. So we are all learning and growing, and we all have this traditional, this modern and postmodern aspects of selves or of minds in us. And what I want to invite you is to become more and more conscious about where our attitudes and decisions come from. Sustainable development is not in one quadrant, it's a four-quadrant action. It's not only economic development. And in the last 20 years, we had a lot of economic development. Development is also internal, from egocentric to ethnocentric and to world-centric, for all sentient beings, for our systems, and for the planet. What I'm speaking about comes from the integral approach based on the philosophy of Ken Wilber. And we are not right and have not all solutions. We are learning, and we are learning through making mistakes. But we are learning for our humanity, for women, for children, for animals, and for the planet. And this also is a development. When people start to be conscious about what they do, they start with human rights, then come women's rights, then children's rights. And now we speak about animal rights and also for the systems. And here come some tools for this view, for this integral view. Leadership is an important issue to bring transformation into organizations. We have seen some systems in autocratic, in democratic, and now we speak about sociocratic or holocratic models. And here you can see a picture how we can transform an autocratic organization from hierarchy to holarchy. It's not so difficult, but it takes time and it needs the personal development of people in the organizations. Okay. And another approach is the spiral dynamics approach. It offers a developmental perspective on values. We have used three levels of development, traditional, modern, and postmodern, but there are many approaches which use more levels. And we need all together, nature, culture, science, and spirit. Thank you.